Rogers Center in Toronto. It's the home of the Blue Jays and the site of our game. The American League East, a battle between Toronto and Boston here at the home of the Jays. Hi again, everybody, along with Steve Phillips and John Kruk. I'm Gary Thorne. Welcome. And let's glance at Toronto's starter. And Steve, as he gets into this Boston lineup, what are we going to see?
I've got a good right-hander on the mound and a good lineup that he's facing right here. And it's going to come down to execution on either side to see who prevails.
This is how the Red Sox are lining up. Now, John, anyone in particular we should keep an eye on?
Well, Jacoby Ellsbury is a guy you don't want to put on base in the top of the lineup. He can walk, he can steal bases, and he's also a power threat at the plate.
First pitch of the game will be to Jacoby Ellsbury. Red Sox lost last night. Not a good run for them right now. They've dropped their last four.
You know, it's so easy to sit here in the booth and point out what's going wrong, but it's harder to make those changes when you're down there on the field. They've dropped four games in a row coming into this one.
Strike one. And a swinging strike on the first pitch from Sanchez, 0-1. John, these kinds of changes, of course, aren't a given. What you're trying to do is find a strategy that gives you that W.
Yeah, and the skipper can make all kinds of changes, but if those changes don't work, the losing streak's going to continue. But you've got to try to find maybe someone on the bench to come in and give this team a spark.
You're out!
And a swing and a miss, strike three on Ellsbury.
When you're getting guys out with three pitches, you know you're dominating.
That's a time when you know you are definitely in the zone, and he was on that at bat. And we'll take a quick look at the Blue Jays and their defensive alignment. Infield, outfield factors in this one, John?
Well, when you have a monster bat like Jose Bautista, you look for so many ways to get him out on the field. And it makes the manager's job a lot easier when your best offensive player is willing to play different positions. It adds a lot of flexibility to the team and also tells your guys that if they ask a lesser player to move position, he can't complain when your best player does it.
Ball! Outside as Pedroia takes it for a ball. Another year of relative health for Dustin Pedroia, always consistent in that lineup, creating runs, getting on base. He's a very tough out.
Strike
and
one.
A called strike on Sanchez's pitch evens it at one. And with Pedroia's relative health on the year, 141 games, that's a total you'll take out of him anytime you can get it. He's still at 15 home runs, 20 stolen bases.
A prototypical top of the lineup guy. You know, great in the number two spot in the lineup. He makes contact, he can work the count, he can hit for average and for power and steal a base. Love the way he plays.
That one's on the ground, but he gets it in front of him.
Ball.
Outside for a ball, and it's full, 3-2.
Trying to get the ground ball out, you throw that two-seam fastball away from the hitter, trying to get him to reach and roll over it. He laid off of it here.
Swung on, lined over the first baseman's head. That one's in there. The Red Sox get one. He'll hold there at second base. Credit him with a double.
Well, this pitch right here catches way too much of the plate, and he absolutely demolishes it. Let's see what they want to do here with one out and a base open.
It's David Ortiz in the box now. Swing, and oh, he shatters his bat as he hits this one on the ground. Two down. And be sure to tune in next Wednesday. We'll be at Busch Stadium, the home of the St. Louis Cardinals, who host the Cincinnati Reds. Things will get going at 1:30 Eastern.
Well, Gary, fans are going to want to tune into that one because I think that's got a chance to be a heck of a ball game.
In the batter's box, Saltalamacchia. And on third, two outs. Sanchez gets set and delivered.
Strike one.
Took something off, and it swung on and missed, 0-1.
That changeup away is one of the most effective pitches because when the hitter's fooled, he starts to pull off the ball. He can only hit an inside pitch. He can't
strike
possibly
two.
Reach the outside pitch unless he breaks down his swing.
Strike Fastball swung on and missed. Side retired. They pick up no runs on a hit. Stranding man at third base. So it'll be the Toronto Blue Jays. Bottom half of the first. Going to be Clay Buchholz on the mound. He'll get the start for Boston. Steve, he's got to focus here. Toronto hitters, what's he thinking about?
You know, Clay Buchholz has a good fastball, but he doesn't use it as much as I'd like to see him use it. I'd like him to use it more. He loves his breaking pitch and changeup and sometimes falls in love with that. I think he needs to use a balanced assortment of his pitches.
Strike one. And he looks at a fastball in there, 1-1. Toronto won last night. That made it 5 in a row, and they'd like to try and make it 6. 1-1 is a changeup that misses, 2-1. Their offense in the last W proves strong in the middle.
Well, a lot of times hitters take a while to get used to pitchers, and in the middle of this game, that's when this offense really took off.
That one swung on, hit in the air, deep to left field. This one to Victorino as he drops back and puts it away. We'll take a moment to look at the Blue Jays lineup. So who are you looking at, John?
Well, every time I watch Troy Tulowitzki play, I am in awe of the things he can do on the field. You just don't see players that physically big that can play the shortstop position with such grace as he can.
Here's a look at how the Red Sox will line up defensively. And scouting those fielders, John.
Will Middlebrook manning the hot corner at third base for his team today. A lot of things he can do. Great fielder, but what you want to watch is he has an unbelievable throwing arm.
Ball. And Buchholz misses. That one's going to be low.
You know, as a dismal season as it was in 2012 for the Red Sox, one positive for them was at least they were competitive on the road. They didn't finish over 500, but they did rack up more wins on the road than they did at home.
And it's fouled off. Oh. And thinking back to what Steve was saying about the Red Sox, not sure if that says more about their play on the road or how bad they were at home.
Well, it says a lot about a lot of things with this team, but I think biggest thing with this team, there's so much drama around it, starting in 2011 at the end of the season with all the talk, continuing into 2012 with the new manager and everything that happened with that. I think maybe this team now with another...
Swung on, that is hit. And that's a base hit. Donaldson on. Here's the schedule for the Red Sox early on this season. They wrap up this Toronto series on Sunday. And after that, they will be home against the Orioles, have to deal with Nick Markakis and the O's lineup. That'll get underway Monday. Following that, they'll have to deal with Evan Longoria, the Rays coming to town. A little bit of a light schedule on tap for them. I think they expect to be winning over the stretch. And Jose Bautista at the plate, a runner on first. Jose Bautista has arguably been the best source of power in the majors over the last few years. 54 homers in 2010, 43 and 11. 27 was leading the way last year when he got injured. Strike started off the at-bat 0-1. Going back to Bautista, fans got what they wanted last year when they saw him compete in that home run derby. He had finished second, but man, did he crush some balls.
I mean, to call him a late bloomer with power is just an understatement. Before his breakout season in 2010.
Hit on the ground, and he's up with it. Over to second for one. And there's the second out, a double play. No runs, one hit, and no one left on base. Both teams still looking for that first. Well, we won't consider it extreme weather, but it is very cold here. Field conditions are okay. Middlebrook's in the batter's box. He waved at that breaker and misses, and an 0-1 count.
Guys, coming off of a game last night, a little bit disappointing. A couple of strikeouts, and he just expanded the strike zone to chase pitches off the plate.
Sanchez gets set and delivers. Middlebrooks watches it low for a ball. The 1-1 on the way. Watches that fastball go by, and now he's at 1-2. And the 1-2 from Sanchez. Swung, ground ball to short. And that'll retire Middlebrooks.
A chance here to check out the Boston Red Sox and how they ranked in the American League last year. First in doubles, fifth in batting average with runners in scoring position. And offensively, scoring runs is the name of the game. And they got that done, ranked in the top five in the league in scoring runs. It shows the ability to score in so many different ways.
And in the batter's box, it's Ross. Batting 3-for-9 lifetime off the Blue Jays. Swung and a fly ball. That's two gone.
The hitter was hoping this ball would go foul and out of play. The right fielder stayed with it all the way, making a nice catch in foul territory.
The chance with two down for Johnny Gomes. This is his 11th year.
Strike one!
And Sanchez has him 0-1 with that called strike. Here's the pitch.
Strike
two, no balls, two strikes. Gomes will protect. Fastball is a waste pitch that time, 1-2.
You're out.
Strike three, Johnny Gomes on a swing and a miss. Nothing doing here in this half inning. We've still got the shutout here at Rogers. Leadoff hitter, Edwin Encarnacion. And the elite home run leader in the top five last season.
Ball.
And the pitch from Buchholz, too far inside for a ball. Here's the 1-0.
Ball.
Change up just off the black. Ball's behind, 2-0.
Well, this guy's changeup is so good that a lot of hitters almost forget about his fastball, but it's that speed differential that makes it so effective.
That swung on and a liner here. And that'll put Encarnacion on at first. That will bring up Russell Martin.
And a chance to see where Edwin Encarnacion ended up in the rankings last year. Third best in RBIs, fourth in home runs, and he was also ranked in the top five in on-base percentage, a real asset for his team. To give his team a chance to score runs and have the run producers drive them in.
Foul!
It's fouled off. Here's the 0-1 pitch by Buchholz.
1-1.
Good eye by Russell Martin. Stays away and it's even. He had a 2-for-4 last year off Buchholz. Here's the pitch.
Ball two.
That's taken low for a ball. 2-1.
Well, this curveball just drops right off the table. It's a good pitch. Give the hitter credit for not chasing.
Foul ball.
It's fouled away. There's a swing, and that one's hit on the ground. And there's one. And they turn the double play. Execution on that 6-4-3.
You have to have body control around the bag. Great acrobatic turn by the second baseman. Outstanding job.
And Troy Tulowitzki to bat.
Really making a difference right now, which is always a good thing. He's gone 5 for his last 11 at bats.
And the manager has to be tickled to death to have a guy that's always on base for the guys behind him.
Here's the delivery.
Ball!
Fastball just misses. 1-0. Batting 3-for-9 lifetime off the Red Sox. Towards the middle. And Tulowitzki's got a single. And that's going to bring B.J. Upton to the plate.
I've got a moment to take a look back to last year's Toronto Blue Jays. Fifth in home runs. Fifth in stolen bases. and they were in the top 10 in runs. An offense that was relentless, that ability to continue to put the pressure on the opposition and take pressure off their own pitching staff.
It's hit foul by Upton. Ground ball, Pedroia. Throws to first, side is returned. They pick up no runs on two hits and strand one. Both teams still looking for that first run here in Toronto. For those of you just joining in, I'm Gary Thorne along with John Kruk and Steve Phillips. We bring you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. And it's Shane Victorino at the plate. Ball. No luck that time for Sanchez as he misses inside. One-oh on the way. Shot back to first. And this could be extra bases heading towards the corner. So, with nobody out, he's aboard at second after that double.
Well, it's so important for your team to get guys on base and in scoring position early in the inning. And that's exactly what he did with that double.
And it's Ciriaco at the plate. Batting 300, that's a 3-for-10 performance last year against the Blue Jays here in Toronto. And he watches the outside pitch from Sanchez for a ball. Called strike on the outside corner, and it's 1-1. Now the 1-1. The 1-1 delivery, a curve in there. Now it's 1-2. And Martin's calling for the pitch.
You're out!
Fastball swung out and missed, struck him out, one away.
That's a pretty fast pitch right there, and hard to get that much break on it.
I think the pitcher had him fooled on this one all the way through, John. He wasn't expecting that outside corner delivery.
Well, he just pulled the string on that pitch, and that's good, good stuff right there.
Chance to drive in a run for Jacoby Ellsbury.
He's been off his game just a little bit, just three hits in his last 13. A tough trend for him as a leadoff guy. You need to get on base and set the table for your lineup. He's got to pick it up for his offense.
Now the first pitch.
Strike one!
And Sanchez has him 0-1 with that called strike. Couldn't put anything in play and went down swinging the first time against Sanchez.
And on the last strikeout, he swung and missed on a two-seamer. I bet he's going to see that again right here. Why wouldn't he?
Well, it's been a very successful strikeout pitch for him, Steve. Definitely. Two other batters have also been put away with it.
On the way. Fastball got him, two down. Boy, a nice looking set of pitches that time. He didn't dattle around with the strike zone.
Now nothing wasted, just three pitches over the plate. Sits him down.
So with two down, it'll be Dustin Pedroia. Mixing your pitch types, key to performance like the one we're seeing today on the mound. Here's a look at what he's been doing.
Well, he's done exactly that. He's changed speeds. He's mixed up all his pitches. And the great thing is he's throwing them all for strikes.
It's unpredictability. The hitters can't think along with him. They don't know what he's going to throw next, keeping them off balance.
Victorino's on at second. And the first pitch, he makes contact, line drive. And that one is in there, his second hit today. And the run is in.
Well, the starting pitching in this game has been absolutely outstanding. So coming through right there in the clutch to bring that first run of the game across has to build confidence for the rest of his team.
And a runner on, David Ortiz batting. And this could be a turning point in this ballgame, guys. Getting that edge so important, and they've done it here.
And you just don't know how important it is to get that early lead, guys. I mean, they've definitely shown their offense is able to produce.
This one's pretty well hit to deep left center. That one's grabbed. Side retired. Third inning. Offense able to get a run in. Boston with the lead. 1-0. We'll be looking to the leadoff. Look at the game from the moves that have been made by John Farrell. Things have been going right for him. His ball club today, last half inning, they proved productive. Now they're looking to expand that lead. And Buchholz misses. That one's going to be low. Well, it's keeping up with the hit trends in this one. Let's take a look at the pitches that he's thrown on the mound that have been put in play.
Well, you look at how he's done with this cutter. It's been hit three times here in this one.
But even though he's only been hit three times in this game, they've all come off of that one pitch. He's been solid to start the game out and could turn into a great start for his club if he continues to minimize hits.
Back up the middle. That looks like a single.
Well, this sort of hit starting out the inning, even though it's just a single, deflating as a pitcher, because now he has to pitch out of the stretch. He has to concern himself with the bunt, but he also has to concern himself with giving up that big inning.
Now their rookie center fielder will take his first shot at the plate. Ball! First pitch is a curveball outside, 1-0. A 1-0 pitch. Swing and a hot shot. Oh, dive, Pedroia. And he gets the force at second. That is a tremendous defensive effort. Well, here's a double play that looked like they ordered up.
Great turn and throw at second base. He was ready to make the play. An example of a nicely executed double play.
Up now, their second baseman. He flew out his last time up. Starts him out here. And Buchholz is wide that time. That's going to be a ball.
The key to a great changeup is deception and velocity change. He has both of those, and that's why it's so good.
Swings, lines this one back up the middle. Makes its way through for a single. It's going to bring Josh Donaldson. Now we have a moment to look at which teams went the yard most last year. The Yankees, number one. The Orioles, second. Third, the White Sox. Fourth spot, Rangers. And for the Blue Jays, they are in fifth.
Well, this team lives and die with the home run ball. They were one of the top teams in the league last year at hitting the ball out of the ballpark, and they seem to want to continue that in this season. They have so much power and depth throughout this lineup that every one of these guys can hurt you.
The pitch.
Ball one.
Outside as Donaldson took it for a ball. What's he doing to start these hitters out? Let's take a look at how he's beginning.
Well, the 1-0 count, let's take a look at what it means here. And obviously it means trouble as he's given up a bunch of hits. When he falls behind on the count, the hitter has the advantage.
Toronto, here's a position to get something done.
Well, two hits the last game, and you can see he was getting a little confidence as that game went on. And he's carrying it into this one with another good start.
Jose Bautista now will stand in. A 1-for-4 last year against Buchholz.
Oh,
too far outside, 1-0. A 1-0 now.
Oh.
Fastball low, 2-0.
Strike.
Good action to that cutter. Called strike, 2-1.
Well, if he could throw this cutter down and away like this, he's going to be very effective. That's an outstanding pitch.
Come set. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Here's a swing and a liner to left center. And yet another hit there, seeing the ball well. And he scores.
And the manager, you know, has to be watching every pitch at this point, wondering if this lineup has figured something out with their third straight hit.
Edwin Encarnacion looking to knock in a run here. His club knew it had to match some production here, and they've done it.
Okay, that was a great piece of hitting right there. Allowed them to pull it even here early in the game. Nice response.
And he'll start him out.
Ball!
Fastball taken high. 1-0. And you get a feeling early on this ball game is up for grabs. This could be anybody's.
Well, it's certainly going to be a battle. I don't think there's any question about that.
Who did Encarnacion get that one? Toronto takes the lead. They were tied, now up by three. That's a big knock. Yeah. Little warm-up action going in the bullpen. That's a right-hander up and throwing.
Well, they're going to wait for the right-handed hitter on deck to get announced, and then they'll probably make the move to the pen.
A three-run homer. You see the WPA graph. That one did some damage.
Gary looked like he was setting on that pitch. He got it and drove it out of the park.
What they're going to want to do in this ballgame now is take advantage of that and build that momentum.
Well, they need to still be aggressive out there. Go right after.
You know, right now for Toronto, they've done what they had to. Gotten the big hits, as we've seen so far, to put themselves out in front. They have the momentum now, so let's see if they can keep it going.
That one taken by Martin for a strike. Well, these guys, I guess, with the big fly, the inning they were hoping for, you got to love the instant production, John.
Instant production and great momentum early here. Now it's time for the pitching to step up and bear down.
Exactly, John. Whoa. Another mistake like that one, and they are going to dig themselves into an even deeper hole. Whoa. Taps this one foul off to the left. The pitch from Buchholz.
Foul ball!
And that's another foul ball.
But what you're looking for when you're behind in a count is you hope the pitcher makes a mistake. In this case, though, he didn't. He made a great pitch down in the strike zone. But give the hitter credit. He gets up on that bat a little bit, choking up, and keeps it in play to keep the at-bat alive.
All three!
Low ball, Martin.
Well, third inning of this ballgame, Gary, clearly he's run into a little bit of a brick wall and up over 20 pitches right here.
Buchholz readies the full count pitch. Martin grounds it. Ciriaco throws to first in time. That's three down. Tough inning play, Buchholz. We'll have that one big fly ball in the game. And the Red Sox coming up next. In the batter's box, Salta Lamacchia. Take a look at this first pitch delivered and see how he's doing.
The first pitch of an at-bat may be the most critical pitch of the at-bat, especially when you get strike one. He's gotten six hitters out today when he's gone 0-1 in the count.
And a one-ball count as we get going here in the fourth. Not an 0-for-1 tonight against Sanchez.
Well, that last time up, he struck him out on the two-seam fastball. I bet we see that.
Now here's a grounder towards the hole. Oh. And his throw is in time. First down of the inning. Now look at the teams who led the league in extra base hits last year. The Yankees, number one. Second, the Rangers. Third spot, the Red Sox. Fourth, the Orioles. And fifth best, the A's.
Well, anytime you have a whole team of guys who can hit for extra bases, it makes the defense spread out so much, and it gives you room to do other things. This team is great at it, one of the best in the league last year, just hitting the balls in gaps, hitting the ball over the wall, and that's why they score so many runs, because they're always in scoring position.
One and one. Will Middlebrooks watches that one go by. The count is even. He had two hits and 70 bats last year against the Blue Jays here in Toronto. Swinging and a miss, and it's now 1-2.
What a phenomenal effort. I mean, Sanchez has been so, so good. Phenomenal.
Here's a chance to take a look at how this pitcher has been doing in terms of getting hitters to chase pitches outside the zone.
Well, he's really locked in right now. Got the hitters off balance, forcing the hitters to swing at pitches outside of the zone, expanding that strike zone.
Unpredictability, that's the toughest thing on any hitter. When you can't guess with the pitcher and you can't guess location, that makes it so difficult.
And that's going to bring David Ross to the plate.
Well, he did his job right there, getting on base. Now with one out, let's see if they can move him around and get him in scoring position.
Popped out, foul ground last time around. Here's the first pitch.
0-1.
Watches a fastball that's in there. 0-1. A 1-for-4 last year against the Jays. Here's the delivery. Here's a swing and a ground ball. This a great situation for some offense.
Wasn't sure when that pitch came to that outside portion of the plate, if he was going to lay back on that one or pull it.
And this defense didn't know either, John. They ended up with a great execution of opposite field hitting.
And he's right where he wants to be, sitting on base now, guys.
Ball!
And Gomes watches, and that's going to be outside. In his first trip to the plate, he went down on strike, striking out against Sanchez.
He saw the changeup as the put-away pitch in his last at-bat. You got to believe he's got to be looking for it somewhere during strike this at-bat as well.
Let's the 1-0 pitch go by, 1-1. Gomes will take it up high. His career average, .257 lifetime off Toronto. Hit in the dirt. The dive, and he's got it. And he throws in time for the force at second. Great out. Take a look here in that dive and that force out.
You see him get down on his belly, make the play, then transfer the ball from glove to hand to get the force out at second.
And here's what the Blue Jays' schedule looks like. Sunday, they wrap up the Boston series. Then on the road, they're going to see the Tigers and one of the outstanding players in the league, Brennan Bosch. Great series there. That gets started on Tuesday. And following that, the road series will go to Kansas City, and they'll face Billy Butler, a team that will definitely give them a competitive series. And quite a bit of time away from home for them over these next several games. First pitch to Victorino.
Strike one!
And Sanchez has him 0-1 with that called strike.
The key to hitting the changeup, if you commit early, you have to keep your hands back. His hands went with the body. He couldn't swing.
And here's the pitch. Swung on and ripped towards second. Out. Throw in time forces him at second for the third out. They pick up no runs on two hits and strand one. Toronto's in charge here. We'll have the 6, 7, and 8 hitters coming up next. And it's Troy Tulowitzki down to lead it off. He's 1-for-1 so far. Through the pitching, Koji Uehara, as they make the pitching swap. Tulowitzki makes contact, fouled off.
Foul! One and one.
And he leaves that one alone. Troy Tulowitzki, good patience, even count.
Well, that right there is a really good pitch, just missing the outside corner. Give the batter a lot of credit, though. That is one of the toughest pitches to lay off of, that hard fastball away.
Foul!
On the way. Swung on, hit. Oh, mercy. That did not miss him by much, but he got out of the way. And that's going to bring B.J. Upton to the plate.
He takes this 1-2 pitch down in the zone. He's able to go down and get it. Get a good part of the bat on the ball and pick up the base hit.
That's a tough pitch to hit. When you're behind in the count, you just want contact, and he got it.
B.J. Upton is an electrifying player. Great speed, great throwing arm, and he finally, in 2012, looks like he figured out that power stroke that we've been waiting to see.
Grounded out his last time up. At the belt, the 1-0. It's hit foul by Upton.
Foul!
Here's the pitch.
Ball.
Good-looking fastball. Call the ball, though, 2-1. 228, not a good lifetime number against the Red Sox.
And it just seems like there's always that one team that you struggle against, and this happens to be the team for him.
All three!
And that misses the outside corner. We'll run it full, 3-2. Spotted by Ross. Grounder, Middlebrooks. There's one, and there's two, a double play.
Yeah.
Nice pickup on that one, then around for two.
That's like infield drills in the pregame, except this time they got two outs. Nice work to get the double play.
It's going to be Saunders. He singled his last trip. First pitch on the way here.
Foul!
And it goes foul. Here's the pitch.
Strike two.
Strike two there. Uehara way ahead of the count.
Well, the way to keep the ball in the ballpark is by going down and away. It's the toughest pitch to drive. He executed it well.
Ball.
Tries to ring him up with the fastball away, but it's one and two.
Ball.
Tried to get him to chase the fastball away, two and two. Swing, hot shot. Oh, my. How did he get out of the way of that? Those are scary. Now with two down, and he's got a man on board.
Well, the last thing you want to do is have a quick inning. That two-out hit right there will prolong the inning. Great piece of hitting.
With this break, a look at the teams who recorded the most steals from last season. The Twins, number one. Second, the Angels. Third, the Rays. Fourth spot held with the Royals. And for the Blue Jays, they are in fifth.
There's nothing like the stolen base. To me, as a guy who couldn't steal a lot of bases, it is
grounder, Middlebrooks, and he's got it. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this half inning. They pick up no runs on two hits and strand one. Four complete. And it's Cerianco at the plate. And taking a look here, the pitch types that he's thrown today that have yielded hits.
Well, his fastball's been put in play, and that two-seamer's been hit three times.
You know, with the hits he's given up off of that pitch, I don't think he's going to use it much more as he works his way through the lineup. But overall, you've got to be pleased with how he's competed.
And he's out in front on that pitch, so he's in the hole now, 0-2.
See if he can't continue what he did last night when he picked up a couple hits.
Fouled away.
You're
big
out.
Swing and a miss on a heater. Strike him out, one down.
Well, he climbs the ladder on him, Gary. He just didn't have enough bat speed to catch up to that pitch.
And it's Jacoby Ellsbury at the plate. Take a look here in his last at bat. He struck out swinging against Sanchez.
Well, listen, I've got to be thinking right now on the mound that he's going to have a hard time picking up that two-seam fastball and give him another look at it.
Well, right now that pitch is just buzzing up there. Got him two times with it, and three others in the lineup have had their at-bats end the same way.
And it's 0-2. Ellsbury cut it down, protect. Well, guys, you know, one of the more interesting types of analyses here, look at his location distribution.
I think he's been in pretty good command in this one. He clearly is hitting his target, if not all the time, at least the majority of the time.
No, John, if I'm the pitching coach, I'm going to emphasize just stick with the plan. The plan seems to be working.
One-two pitch coming. Good eye there. Jacoby Ellsbury lays off it to even the count.
Got to be feeling good today. Picked up a couple hits in the game last night.
Here's the pitch. Swing and a line drive. Pilowitzki able to pull that one in.
Well, this ball's tattooed. It's flying off the bat, and the shortstop is right there to glove it for the out.
So with two down, it'll be Dustin Pedroia. Had an RBI single his last time to the plate. Here's the first one. Swing and lined up the middle. And he gets it down. That's his third hit, 3-for-3. That brings up David Ortiz.
He's having one heck of a game, isn't he, Gary? Up to three hits now for the game. And we'll see if they can bring him home with two outs.
Last time up, flew out. And starts him out here. That swung on, hit on the ground. Number 29. Throw over to second base, a force to retire the side. So no runs on one hit and nobody left on. Toronto not letting this lead go. Last inning, that pitching gave up nothing. That's what he wants to see. Now looking for the offense to try and expand the lead. He swings and drives this one. This one to Ellsbury. comes up with it easily here. And Donaldson's turn to hit. He singled and later scored in his last time up. We'll see what he sees first here. This one's bounced up the middle. Picked up by Middlebrooks. Retiring Donaldson. And a moment now to recap our on-base percentage leaders from last year. There you see Encarnacion. He's number five.
But there's no more valuable player in the lineup than a guy who can get on base and get on base often. And this guy's one of the best at it in baseball. He has so many different ways he can get on base. The thing is, he makes the pitcher work so much harder that you don't see a lot of starting pitchers finishing games against his team because of his ability to work counts.
There's a swing and a drive deep to left field. This one to Victorino. And that's the third out. That'll do it. Well, how about that? Only needed four pitches to set down the guys. Tremendous. Blue Jays. In the batter's box, Saltalamacchia. First pitch on the way.
Ball.
And he watches the outside pitch from Sanchez for a ball.
He went with the big curveball off the plate, trying to get him to reach for it, but he lays off.
Here's the 1-0.
Foul!
And it's fouled away. The pitch. Curveball just off the black, and it's 2-1. The 2-1 pitch.
Strike
That's
two.
On the black for a strike. Evens the count at 2-2.
If the hitter pulls the trigger on this, he's got a chance to drive the ball. He opened up, was out in front, but the inside changeup can be dangerous.
You're out.
Strike three called on the fastball. What a way.
This is the effective use of the fastball. You can move it around the zone and hit your spots. They go down and in right there. Looks like the hitter was thinking away.
So with one down, it'll be Will Middlebrooks. Already one hit in the ballgame, 1-for-2 off Sanchez.
Yeah, he wasn't too fazed by that curveball that he saw the last time.
Hit up the middle, and in there, he's 2-for-3 today. And that's going to bring David Ross to the plate.
Well, he waited for that one to get deep in the zone, and he put a good swing on it. Now, with one out, let's see if they try to move him along.
Now a look at the teams who generated the most runs last year. The Rangers, number one, the Yankees, second. The Angels third, fourth the White Sox, and it's the Red Sox number five.
Well, the thing you ask your team, the manager and the hitting coach, is, look, guys, get us some runs. This team does it as good as anyone in the league last year, and they just love to get on base, make things happen with speed, but they can also take it out of the ballpark.
Swung on, hit in the air to right center. This one to Bautista. He's taking charge, puts it away.
This one looked like it might fall in no man's land out there, but the right fielder able to get over and put him away.
Runner on for Johnny Gomes. He hit for a .300 average last year against the Blue Jays at Rogers Center. Sanchez gets set and delivered. Swings and misses at the fastball, 0-1. Here it comes. Called strike below the waist, and he's in the hole now, 0-2.
I don't think he's going to waste any time right now. He's just going to go right at him with that 0-2 pitch.
That one fouled off by Gomes.
Foul!
And he watches the outside pitch from Sanchez for a ball.
Well, that's where you look for a changeup from the pitcher away in the strike zone. If they look for it and get it, they can really shoot that thing the other way and do some damage.
You're out!
Struck him out. That's number 8 in the game. No runs on a hit, and they'll strand him. And it'll be the Blue Jays coming right up. Heart of the order due to bat next. Leadoff hitter, Edwin Encarnacion. He homered back in the third. And he starts him out. Hit in the air to center field. They take care of that one. So with one down, it'll be Russell Martin. Great swings at that fastball and misses. 0-1. Good eye by Russell Martin. Stays away and it's even. And Ross setting his target. Swings and grounds this one foul, wide of third. Hard splitter misses. 2-2. He deals.
Foul!
And he swings and hits this one foul. Hit on the ground. Ciriaco. Out number two.
Well, great work on the mound right here. Consistent, solid pitching. Great approach. Retired six consecutive batting.
Here's Troy Tulowitzki. He'll bat with two down. 2-for-2 in the game. First pitch on the way here.
Right,
the fastball is in there. It's 0-1. The pitch. That swung on and a liner here. Throws on to first in time to retire the side. Take a look down there in the bullpen. They've got a lefty up and throwing.
Well, I don't see him coming in just yet. I mean, with a righty in the on.
And if you just joined our broadcast, great to have you on board. 2K Sports Major League Baseball, I'm Gary Thorne. With Steve Phillips and John Cruck. And it's Shane Victorino now. He'll lead off the seventh inning. Take a look down there in the bullpen. They've got a lefty up and throwing.
Well, I don't see him coming in just yet. I mean, with a righty in the on-deck circle, I don't think that's the matchup they want.
Now the 1-0 pitch.
Ball.
Fastball just misses, and he falls behind 2-0.
Oh, 9 outs to go right now and leading by 3. I mean, I think you have to start throwing strikes. Just go at the hitters. Force them to put in play. Do not give them free passes.
And apparently it's time. Obviously a little struggling going on the mound. You look in the pen, they've got two up.
Well, let's hope it's not too late. I mean, this guy's out there. He's really scuffling right now. They've got to make the change.
Pitch on the way. He watches the fastball go by. Now it's 2-2.
Count.
And he holds off of the change, and it's full. The 3-2 pitch.
You're out!
He got him. That's 9 Ks now.
Now, good pitch right at the knees there. He swung right over the top of it and just couldn't put it in play.
And it's Ciriaco at the plate. He struck out swinging his last time. And the first pitch. Line drive. That's fouled towards first. No balls, one strike. Sanchez. And he fouls off another one.
Foul!
Ooh. he lays off that one high and away, 1-2.
Offensively now, they've got to start to work the count. They've got to try to get base runners on and get things going here. I mean, you've got one out here in the seventh inning. It's not too late to try to make up some of this deficit.
Grounded softly to short. Picked up by Tulowitzki.
Yeah.
And a good throw gets him two down. And a chance here with two down for Jacoby Ellsberg. 0 for 3 to this point. And time is called. So we're going to see if they want to make a move here or just buy a little time.
I'm not sure they're going to make the switch right now. It's going to be interesting to see which way they go.
Hi. And Brett Cecil, he gets ready to throw. He'll be relieving for the Blue Jays now. And Steve, as he faces these Boston hitters, what will be the focus?
Well, Brett Cecil has a very clean delivery. The ball jumps out of his hand and gets on the hitters. He gets a lot of ground ball outs as well. The secondary stuff is still improving.
Here's the pitch. Got the bat on that one. This one's hit towards Bautista. That one's grabbed. Side retired. And they're held in check here in this half inning. Blue Jays still out in front. Trying to make the decisions to bring a W. Let's see how it's going. The thoughts of a manager. One can only speculate, but at this point, you got to believe he's got some words for that next practice. And B.J. Upton to bat. 250 is average last season against the Red Sox. Swings and misses the splitter. 0-1.
When you can locate this pitch away and have that kind of sinking action on it, you're going to get a lot of ground ball outs.
Here's the delivery. He makes contact. Line drive. Ooh, that one hit off the heel of his glove.
Gary, I tell you what, I think he caught that one in self-defense. He couldn't even move. He had to just get the glove up.
It's going to be Saunders. Had a base hit his last time up. Starts him out here. This one's grounded foul, wide of first. Strike two there. Uehara way ahead of the count.
Well, it's tough to tell a hitter to stay back on a fastball, but this is what he needs to do. He's jumping out trying to get to it, and is just way out in front.
Oh, tries to ring him up with a fastball away, but it's 1-2. The 1-2 pitch.
Oh,
that
two.
Misses the strike zone away to even things at two. He delivers. Swing and a chopper to the second baseman. Ends up foul.
You're out.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, second out in the inning.
The two strikes, the hitter wanted the fastball. He got it, but didn't do anything with it.
Hi.
Now there's center fielder at the plate. He was set down with a ground out in his prior at bat. 0 for 2 thus far. There's a swing, line drive, center field. And that gets through for a base hit.
Well, anytime you bring in a relief pitcher to come in a key situation, the last thing you want to do is for him to serve one up to the first hitter. That's exactly what he did, giving up that big base hit.
And it rolls around to the top again. Flew out last time. Now the first pitch.
Strike
fastball one. In there, 0-1. The pitch.
Ball.
Low for a ball, 1-1.
Strike
And he watches one at the knees, and it's 1-2.
Velocity and location are absolutely critical. That pitch was exactly where he wanted to throw it.
The 1-2 on its way.
Oh!
Swung on and fouled away.
Can't
catch that low outside corner. We're even at two. The pitch.
You're out.
And this is a slider in there. Called strike three. That'll do it. No runs at a base hit. They leave one man on at first. Blue Jays, 4. Boston, 1. Two hole to get things started now. And Dustin Pedroia to lead it off. Drove in a run earlier in the game. The first pitch.
Ball!
That one's going to be outside. Ball one.
Obviously getting late right now, Gary, and I think that from the pitching perspective, you'll trade an out for a run at this stage of the game, understanding that for every out you get, you're closer to winning.
Strike one.
And he looks at a fastball in there, 1-1. One one on the way. Now a swing, pops him up, left side of the infield. One away. So with one away, here's David Ortiz. He's at an even 200 lifetime against Brett Cecil.
Well, and the scales are leaning toward the pitcher in this matchup, so it goes through the hitter's mind. He knows he struggles against him.
And Ortiz ready for the first pitch.
12
strike in the inner half, 0-1.
Well, so much for the questions. Is Big Poppy done? We heard that in the past, but he's continuing to prove he's got some baseball left. He's an RBI machine.
Good patience as David Ortiz lets that one go by. The count is even. Well, for David Ortiz, certainly an RBI machine when he's healthy. Missed a good deal of time last season, but still looks like he can be that big DH. That one swung on, hit in the air to deep right center field. And Bautista runs it down.
This ball was well hit. The ball looked like it was going to carry deeper. The right fielder had just enough time to slide over and put it away.
In the batter's box, Salta Lamacchia. Last year, just an 0-for-1 off Cecil.
Hi.
Number 31 will be coming in to pitch in this game. He'll be relieving for the Blue Jays now. First pitch, a sinker in there, 0-1.
Now listen, this is still doable from the offensive perspective, Gary. They're only down 3. It would be nice to have a little 2-out rally right here, pick up some runs, narrow this 3-run deficit. But understand, you can still come back and finish it tonight. Just don't wait till the ninth.
Ball.
Tried to get him to chase that curve. It's 1-2.
They went with the big curveball off the plate, trying to get him to reach for it, but he lays off.
Curveball, that tied him up and not swung on and missed. Side retired. And they aren't able to get anything going in this half inning. 3-up, 3-away. Now, Blue Jays, home half of the 8th inning. Leading off, Josh Donaldson. Grounded out last time through. Swings, hits this one. It'll be fielded by Ellsbury. One away.
Boy, got a pitch to hit right there, but just a little bit out in front. Sends an easy fly ball to center field for the out.
Time to take a look at who led the league in slugging percentage last season. There you see Encarnacion. His number swung on. That is hit. And that one's through for a base hit. Second hit in the game. 500 today.
The infield played it deep like they knew he was going to swing away. He did, but was still able to find a hole.
So, the opportunity now will go to Edwin Encarnacion. Here's the first pitch.
Strike
the 0-0 delivery, a fastball taken for a strike. Now 0-2, Preslow's got a few pitches to work with. Here's the pitch.
Ball.
Good slider that time. Ruled the ball. 1-2.
You're out.
And strike three. Encarnacion right through that one.
Now good break on a 90-mile-an-hour pitch. You've got to have better plate discipline than that. With two strikes, you need to be defensive and try to make contact. But when you get a fastball, you need to read whether it's a strike.
It's Russell Martin. Last year, he was 1-for-2 off Preslow. Swing sets this one pretty well. Deep right center. This one into the alleyway. Should be extra bases. Here's Bautista heading home. And he gets there all the way from first.
I like the swing right there by that right-handed hitter. Going the other way with that pitch, exactly what he wanted to do.
John, not where the defense wanted it to go.
No, and that's what happens sometimes. You play a guy to pull, and the ability to hit the ball the other way, not a lot you can do to defend him.
RBI opportunity now with the bat, Troy Tulowitzki. Sometimes you get that head of steam like we're seeing here, and it just keeps on going. Consistency up and down the lineup.
Offense coming to life late here, tacking on additional insurance runs, taking the pressure off the pitcher.
1-0 count. He took that last one, and it was out of the zone. You know, they may not have put it away, but they sure are making it a lot easier for the guys coming out of the pen.
Well, they wouldn't mind making it a little bit easier right now. Another big hit could really put it out of reach here, Gary.
This one swung on and driven hard. This one to Ellsbury. And that's going to do it in this half inning. So they score once on two hits, one man left. It's the Blue Jays by 4. And welcome to those of you just tuning in, 2K Sports, Major League Baseball. This is Gary Thorne along with Steve Phillips and John Crook. Middlebrook's in the batter's box. 2-for-3 thus far. It is a strike to start the ninth, 0-1.
I think right now, offensively, you've got to start getting base runners. Get as many as you can. I mean, you're down a ton, so you don't need big hits. You don't need home runs. You need base runners.
Number 29. One down.
Obviously, you know, winning big right now, you just want to go out there, make plays, throw strikes, force them to try to put multiple hits together to get back into this game.
And in the batter's box, it's Ross. Last time up, flew out. 0-1. Swings and misses. The sinker, 0-1. Watches that one for a called strike. Nothing and two.
Well, they set up down and away. They throw it down and away. That's how you can be effective as a major league pitcher.
Fastball got him. Two down.
Well, two strikes, you have to try to fight off this pitch. You have to think away and adjust in. They went away, but he couldn't make contact.
The chance with two down for Johnny Gomes. He hit for a 300 average last year against the Blue Jays.
Strike one!
And a fly ball, and this could be it. That's going to be a route. Final out of the ball game.
Well, it's been a great one here today, Gary, and it's all because of the pitching. Outstanding pitching, really leading them to victory.
I think you'll agree, we have got the perfect choice in this one for our player of the game. Edwin Encarnacion, boy, did he step up and take care of business today.
Yeah, I mean, this guy came out and made this team look like world beaters today. A couple of hits, and he went big fly. All in all, it adds up to a nice day's work, and they come away on top.
And Steve, they're able to win this game rather handily. little bit of home cooking here that was right on from the beginning.
Now, Gary, as a player, you always like having the 10th man out there, and these fans provided that today. They were into it.
I guess it's that time again. We wrap up this 2K Sports broadcast of MLB. John, Steve, our entire 2K Sports crew, I'm Gary Thorne. Adieu, adieu.